Hello, my name is Matthew Dusenberry, and I am one of our project managers here at Archer Point. And I wanted to put together a quick video to show you how you can do some basic filtering in Business Central, in your Business Central environment, as well as save what, you know, what's called views, so that once you have those set filters set up, you don't necessarily have to do them again. So I'm going to go through a couple basic examples here. So when we drill into the items here, you can see, for example, you've got some information over here, right, regarding views and regarding the ability to search. So for the sake of kind of starting over, I'll go ahead and clear that out. And then over here, you've got a couple of different buttons up here. Number one is we can kind of turn these on right here with this little filter thing. And then if we click here, this will give you an option. If you have some previous filters in here, you can go ahead and save them, and it will show you the filter that you had set up before. So let's go ahead and put this in motion here. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and do a filter. So you can see here that I essentially get an option to set a filter for anything that's in this list view, right? So if I'm in the items, for example, right now, let's just say that I want to search for quantity on hand. I can put a 5 in here, for example, and I can search by quantity of 5, right? So if I want to go ahead and see what do I have that's on hand, what I can do is I can say I'm looking at something greater than 0. So you can see here, right, I was able to filter this, and this is showing me everything in here that's greater than 0. I can do other things in this filter, right? I can say I only want to see items perhaps that maybe have 10. And I can also drill into this a little bit further as well. I could search by other attributes or fields here. I may want to search by, please give me a list of everything, right, that's greater than 0. And we'll just say with the price of greater than 0 as well. So let me show you then how to save that view here. So if we were looking at quantity on hand, and again, using our example of greater than 0, I can see my list here, and then I can save this. And the system is going to prompt you to name it. So we'll just say items not 0, and notice how it gives me the items that are currently larger than 0 on here. Other areas that you can do this is when you start looking at your ledger entries, right? So this will look like this will be your item ledger entries. This could be your vendor ledger entries, right? Your GL entries and such. Conceptually, we're kind of looking at the same thing here. We can click this little button here to turn on our search. And then what we can do is we can start slicing our data from here. Right. So for example, because I'm in the item ledger entries page, I'm going to get everything right that has an item ledger. But let's just say that I'm only interested in transfer shipments. So if I'm going to look at document type, and then this one is drop down driven, I can go ahead and put transfer. Let's do a transfer receipt. And then notice my list only shows this. And then again, if I want to save this for myself, we'll go ahead and give it a name. And then what we'll do is to kind of demonstrate the fact that you only have to do this once, we will navigate out. And what we can do is we can go back in. And then when you do go back in here, it's going to kind of default to that standard view. But I can simply click the view that I created based on my filtering, and I see what, you know, what I set it to be. Now, the one important thing to call out here, right, is even though I filtered this, for example, with these two lines in here, as more entries are created, right, if this was, say, your live production environment, this list would obviously grow. You don't have to set these filters each time to pull in updated transactions or items and such. You know, kind of you can set it and forget it, and it should update with the data based on the filters that you have. And if you find that this filter, right, is no longer beneficial for you, you can simply remove it. If you have any other questions on this or anything else related to Business Central, please reach out to the Archer Point team, and we'll be happy to help. Thank you.